This week in our film experience class, we watched the film Babe, Pig in the City by director George Miller. The film is about a pig named Babe, who gets tangled up in various adventures while he is on a trip to a large city. The film uses many aspects of mise-en-scène, one in particular being its use of lighting, in which it excels at very well. Our textbook, Looking at Movies, describes lighting as creating our sense of cinematic space by illuminating people and things. There are three places where this stuck out to me in particular, one of them being where Thelonious is looking out at Mr. Fugly, who is being placed into the ambulance. While he is doing this, he's being silhouetted by backlighting, making it look like he's wearing all black, and the stained glass almost makes it look like he's at a church, at a funeral. The director did this to try to make the viewers relate to Thelonious. Another notable instance of lighting is in the chase scene. First of all, the scene is set at nighttime and outside, so color correction gels had to be used on any sort of light to make it look like the streetlights. The top lighting also hid the characters' faces and hid their emotions from the viewers, allowing the viewers to put themselves in Babe's shoes and try and feel what he's feeling. Dude, lights. Dude, sick. Dude, look at that. Sick. Dude, sick. Dude. The final instance where I notice an excellent use of lighting is the scene where Fleelick almost dies. The harsh top lighting draws the viewer's eyes to the only thing that's moving, Fleelick's wheel, and keeps our focus there while we watch it slowly come to a stop. Due to the heavy themes and emotions that are in this movie, it probably should not have been marketed for children and more towards adults. The director George Miller, born March 3, 1945, had previous experience directing much darker films, such as Mad Max and the award-winning Lorenzo's Oil. In Lorenzo's Oil, the use of lighting is once again very prominent, and this use comes through in Babe, Pig in the City. While I was watching this movie, I kept thinking about Toy Story 2. Both of these movies are similar in the aspect that they were children's movies that ended up having sequels that are way darker than the original. Going back to the topic, the movie used lighting to help convey characters' emotions and did so very excellently.